dear students, good morning. In continuation of previous lecture, it is topic 4. So, in that lecture I mentioned already that the alchemy means Arabian chemists, they were disgraced, they could not synthesize gold, and later on it was shifted to Greeks again. And then they started discovering, even today that discovery is going on about the matter. Matter is a very serious thing, everything made up of matter, the whole universe. And now they started doing research on this matter, that how matter is gaining mass, from where mass is coming. If you remember, in the first lecture I mentioned that it was Big Bang concept, and lot of explosion was there, shoot out, and planets came, and slowly they started cooling, and then first electron came into existence, and slowly within the fraction of second, then the proton was formed, and the hydrogen and helium came. But after that, the question comes, the one electron came into existence, why, from where it got the mass? Mass means electron today, what according to de Broglie concept, electron can act as particle as well as wave. But light is a photon, is a frequency, is a wave without particle. So that in the form of light, in the form of photon, how they are converted into particle having mass. And that's why the today's worry, lot of scientists are even working today, that from where universe is getting mass, from which source they want to reach to Eve and Adam. So if you remember, in 2008, the biggest accelerator, hadron accelerator, they constructed in Geneva, and they started just to accelerate this photon under that vacuum accelerator with very high speed. And for kind information, before that, actually, the Professor Hick, his name is Professor Hick, and other is Professor Abdul Salam, Nobel laureate. They started working on unification of forces. And that unification of forces means, you know, these planets and Earth, stars, they are having a special type of forces which are governing them. And those special type of forces, one force we call it gravitational force, the second force we call it electromagnetic force, the third force we call it nuclear force. So these forces, if they are unified, definitely they can reach to that conclusion that how mass is coming. Relating to Einstein's theory, E is equal to mc square means energy, frequency, and mass is interconvertible. And if you go by history, I have gone through that letter that he applied in Berlin University, Professor Einstein at that time, and he quoted this paper, E is equal to mc square, relativity concept, and his lectureship request application was rejected, and they mentioned that this theory looks like more artistic rather than scientific. This is historical proof, all in libraries, his letter is there, rejection letter. So what I mean to say, that at that time people were not able to understand. So today they call it God particle. And sometimes they call it Higgs boson. This God particle means they are saying that in that discovery they want to mention that how this particle and mass came into existence. So what there? They are using lot of money, lot of resources. And for your kind information, in that Geneva in 2008, they constructed one super accelerator cordon, that is SLPC, that is high accelerator, and it took 25 years to construct that accelerator, and $37 billion investment, and lot of thousands of scientists from all over the world just to discover that from where mass is coming in space. So still today, our scientists are working what they were working some thousand years before on matter and mass. And I'm afraid that sometimes they may not behave in the same way like alchemy. Those Arabians, they were trying to synthesize gold and they were disgraced. But of course, we have the hope. So there is chance that sometimes they might be successful. So now the latest definition of matter is today that any substance which has mass and occupies space is called matter. And atom is the smallest particle of an element which may or may not exist in free state and which may or may not react with other element. So that is the modern definition of atom. Why we are saying this definition? Because in some books they only write it is the smallest particle of an element. But we have to make it very clear that atom means smallest particle of an element, but its reaction. There are some elements like gold, like platinum, like neon, argon, krypton. They are in native state. They are not showing any reaction. So they may not react. And like platinum, gold, they are found in free state. So they may or may not react. So with this, I will stop today. Thank you very much.